It's important for us to know what kind of effects that or impacts that we have on these animals in general. And that can go from toxic pollutants to acoustic pollutants and also to direct contact with the animals, whether it be by ship or fishing gear. Humpbacks and right whales tend to lift their tails when they dive, whereas finbacks and blue whales tend to not lift their tails when they dive. Because of that, we're not seeing what could have been hooked onto the animal from the caudal peduncle to the tail always.
We looked at our full ID catalog, and then we looked at animals who lifted a little bit more of the tail. And the more of the tail we could see of the peduncle in blue whales and fin whales, the higher the proportion of animals with entanglement scans.
That's why we felt that if we could get up above, we'd have a better view of that part of the body. And when drones came along, it provided a really wonderful tool to be able to look down onto these animals, because we don't see that much of them when they're at the surface.
It's estimating entanglement rates of fin whales using aerial photography.
We had to create a protocol to be able to deal with all these images that we were collecting so that we could make sense of it.
And we had two main questions. We have to identify the scars. And secondly, we have to identify the individuals, because obviously to have the exact sample size and proportion, we not only have to identify the animals with scars, we also have to be certain about the number of animals without scars. And that actually was the more tricky part of the experiment. We took video of the whole body, the dorsal part, the peduncle part, and the tail part. By chance, we filmed one animal this year, and it was subsurface feeding. So actually, we saw both corners of the mouth, and both were heavily scarred. It showed that this is probably where the gear was entangled. So in the end, we got between 42 and 52% of previous entanglements.
One of the things that is interesting is to see how these animals interact. So the aerial view gives us something that we just wouldn't see from the surface.
It will open up completely new fields for looking at the behavior. You can sit there, you work 4 meters away, and observe the animals without disturbance.
We can see contact and see how the animals are maneuvering around each other.
We hope to continue the project for 2 more years and 2 consecutive years with a big sample size.
The more we know about to what percentage this occurs and in what manner and with what gear, the more we're able to change our habits of fishing, for instance, and it helps the policymakers decide how they're going to manage fisheries and shipping in the St. Lawrence, which is a very productive body of water, which has proven to be important to a very good number of different species of marine mammals, which includes blue whales and finbacks.